if God did all of this, that means that the earth is special, but even more so, the men and women that he created on earth for this little tiny period of time are awfully special for some of his purposes. You've once written that this thing of free choice comes into play here. You can program your computer to tell you it loves you, okay? But it's not the same as having a person to freely choose that. Talk a little bit more about the choice that God gave and this tiny window of opportunity for him to solve the problem of evil.
Well, the Bible tells us that God created us to magnify his love, which is the reason why he gave us a free will capacity, so that love would be possible from the creatures to God and God back to his creatures. So it explains why the universe is the way it is, but also explains why we are subject to evil. After all, of our free will, we can choose to obey God or disobey God. And God knew ahead of time what would happen. After all, we were faced with much more powerful, intelligent beings that were already in an evil state. But God in advance designed the universe with the best possible physics so that he could efficiently and rapidly bring about the end of all evil. And what I found unique about Christianity, it's the only religion that gives us a two creation scenario, where God first creates to bring about the end of all evil and then takes us human beings who are so willing into a new creation where evil will never exist again. Why? Because we only get there through our free will being tested by exposure to evil. But God is there to help us pass the tests we can't pass by ourselves.
Talk about the moment that you realized that you had flunked the test and that the help that God provided was sending his own son into the world to die for your sin and how you took advantage of that.
Well, I first started reading the Bible seriously when I was 17. I was very impressed with its moral standard and actually tried to live up to that moral standard and quickly came to the recognition it can't be done. But as I continued to read through the Bible, I realized God had sent the Creator himself to be a human here on earth and to pay the price whereby we could trade our moral imperfection for his moral perfection. That sounded like a great deal, and I signed my name in the back of a Gideon Bible at age 19, saying, yes, I want that trade, but also recognizing I need God's help to fulfill the purpose for which God created me. What I love about the Gideons is they say, God knows better than we do what's best for our life, and it's best to put him in charge of our life. So it's not only receiving the trade, but committing yourself to make the Creator of the universe the master of your life and to allow him to help you pass a test you can't pass by yourself.
Yeah, and scientists that look at all of this information, 850 design characteristics of the universe already that you found that kind of blow your mind to show you how smart God is and how intricate everything is, if he did all of that, then I think he can handle your life if you give him control of your life.
Amen.
That's what he's talking about. And folks, we would say, put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ. He did everything that's necessary for you to have your sins forgiven and you to stand before God unblemished, unblamed, free of your sin.